Hey, good morning, everybody. Today is Friday, October 2nd, 2015. My name is Cliff Backus, and this is your pushbuttonstocktrading.com daily video market review. Stocks took advantage of a late rally to close mostly higher on lighter trading volume yesterday. While most of the indices we follow were up, the mid-cap S&P 400 and the small-cap 600 were both down. The IBD 50 and 8585 both advanced on lighter volume. The IBD indices are continually updated to reflect leading momentum stocks and give us a good idea of where what the leadership is doing. Currently, the leadership appears to be conflicted and directionless. Advancing and declining issues played to a virtual tie yesterday. The New York Stock Exchange advanced decline line is looking a bit less bearish, as despite recent weakness in the market, it hasn't undercut its August 24th low. New lows continue to better new highs. Large capitalization stocks outperformed small yesterday, but small caps continue to outperform on a 10-day moving average basis. This is behavior more typical of a bull market. Our swing timing model is indicating an oversold condition in the market. Our market timing models on both the S&P 500 and the NASDAQ, after having swung to an outright sell signal last week, are back to a primary sell signal with a secondary indication of aggressive buy. What this means is that while most of us should continue to accumulate cash, our most aggressive traders can begin to carefully experiment on the long side, keeping stops at their tightest levels. The O'Neill market timing model is indicating a market in correction and has been since September 25th. Yesterday was day three of an attempted rally for the S&P and day two for the NASDAQ. In order for the O'Neill model to go to a confirmed uptrend, we need to see a follow-through day. A follow-through day is any day at least four sessions into an attempted rally where one of the major averages advances at least 1.25% on heavier trading volume than the prior day. Since Tuesday was day one of the attempted rally, we could see the S&P confirm the new uptrend as soon as Monday's close. That's assuming, of course, that we don't undercut Tuesday's intraday low between now and then. The Russell 2000, which undercut its August 24th low last week, continues to struggle with resistance at that level. Meanwhile, the S&P and the NASDAQ have tested and held their August 25th closing lows. While this market may have more work to do to the downside, and our primary signal on both the NASDAQ and the S&P are on sells, the market looks in much better shape to mount a sustainable rally today than it did just a few weeks ago. That said, be careful with any entries and keep your stops at their tightest levels. This market remains conflicted and will continue to be prone to whipsaws. Remember, our primary market timing signal is a sell on both the NASDAQ and the S&P 500. Be careful. Okay, what we're looking at here is Moody's list of 177 industry groups sorted in HGSI, high growth stock investors, by 5-day percentage price change. The reason that we look at this is that by noting that where the strength in the market is on a daily basis, we can get an idea of where the power in the market is rotating to. The basic premise of momentum trading, which is what we're doing here, is that we need to identify where the power is and get out in front of it. So let's see where the strength in the market has been in the past week. Over the past 5 trading days, technology distributors are up 3.2%. Agricultural product wholesalers, 2.7%. Home and office product wholesalers, 2.6%. Security and commodity exchanges have been up 2.5%. And rounding out the top five is the life insurance index, which is up 2.3%. I want to start today by again taking a look at the Russell 2000. Earlier this week, the Russell 2000 undercut support at its August 24th low. That's the 1102 area. We undercut that support, and then on Wednesday, we retested that level, and we were rejected. Yesterday, the Russell closed lower, again blocking its support at the 1102 area. In order for markets to recover, we need to recapture that 1102 area and preferably do it on significant trading volume. Until that happens, this market isn't going to be a safe place for the bulls. Let's take a look at the NASDAQ composite. The NASDAQ yesterday took advantage of a late day rally to close up 6.92 points or 0.15%. The NASDAQ closed at 46.27. Notice how it closed at the very top of its daily trading range, taking out yesterday's high, but also providing a little bit of hope for the bulls. Trading volume was above average, but it was below the prior day. For you followers of William O'Neill, the market is in correction right now. It has been since September 25th. Right now, the NASDAQ is on day two of the attempted rally. Here's day one, and yesterday was day two. In order for the O'Neill system to confirm the uptrend in the market, we need to have a day where one of the major indexes, the NASDAQ or the S&P 500, advances at least 1.25%. That advance has to come at least 4 days into the attempted rally. Yesterday was day two of the attempted rally for the NASDAQ. So the earliest the NASDAQ could confirm the rally would be the close of business on Tuesday of next week. Right now, the NASDAQ is bracketed by support down here in the 4292 area and resistance up here around 4900. We are currently on a primary sell signal on the NASDAQ with a secondary signal of aggressive buy. What that means is that our most aggressive traders can begin to dabble back in the market. Most of us will want to continue to raise cash. If you do begin to dabble back in the market on the long side, you want to keep your stops at their tightest possible levels. Let's see what the S&P 500 is up to. The S&P, after spending most of the trading session down, closed up 3.79 points or 0.2%. The S&P closed at 1923. Notice how we closed in the very top of our trading range for the day. That gives the bulls a little bit of hope here. Trading volume yesterday was right about average daily. It was below the prior day. The S&P 500 is also in a market in correction and has been since September 25th. The S&P is bracketed by support down here in the 1867 area and resistance up here in the 1993 range. But importantly, the S&P 500 seems to have held support down here in the 1867 area. We'll see if we can take out resistance up here in the 1993 range. The S&P is currently on a sell signal, but like the NASDAQ, it has an aggressive buy signal. So we have a primary signal of sell and a secondary signal of aggressive buy. Before we go, I want to take a look at Black Hawk Network. Black Hawk Network operates a payment network in the United States and 21 other countries to offer gift cards and other prepaid products. The stock right now is working on this first stage base on base pattern with a pivot point of $46.13. Yesterday, the stock traded higher trading volume than any down day in the past 10 trading sessions, which, as we know, is the definition of a pocket pivot. Notice how that pocket pivot carried Black Hawk up through its 21-day exponential moving average, which we show in pink, its 10-day simple moving average, which we show in green, and its 50-day simple moving average, which we show in red. Aggressive traders can buy Black Hawk Industries here on the pocket pivot, keeping in mind that we are on a primary sell signal and that you want to keep your stops at their tightest possible levels. That's about all I have for today. If you want to talk about any of the stocks mentioned today or any of our market strategies, please feel free to give me a call, drop me an email, or make an appointment. Come by the office, see what we're up to. Contact information is on the homepage. For daily access to our model portfolios, trade updates, and more up-to-date information on our trading strategies, please take a minute to go to our subscription page and subscribe to Push Button Stock Trading. You can also follow us on Twitter at Push Button Stock. Again, my name is Cliff Backus. That's your daily video market review. Have a safe and profitable day. Keep your stops in place, and I will see you again tomorrow. Please stay tuned for our important disclaimers. All the best. Disclaimers. Push Button Stock Trading Video Market Review is produced and edited by Clifford B. Backus. Mr. Backus is a Senior Vice President of Investments, Technical Analyst, Portfolio Manager, and Partner with the investment firm of Ohannison LaCours Incorporated. Video Market Review is produced solely for the benefit of our clients, friends, and colleagues. Anything written, stolen, and/or plagiarized in this publication is done without malice. Further, the analysis and opinions expressed in this publication are strictly those of the editor and not of Ohannison LaCours Incorporated, its affiliates, subsidiaries, or any of the officers or employees of Ohannison LaCours Inc. On that note, we submit the following. The analysis, calculations, and evaluations presented herein are based on data and assumptions Ohannison LaCours Incorporated believes to be accurate. Ohannison LaCours Incorporated makes no representation that such analysis or calculations are accurate, or that such valuations represent levels at which actual trades may occur. This report has been prepared from original sources, except where otherwise noted, and data we believe to be reliable. Ohannison LaCours Inc., its affiliates and subsidiaries, and or their officers and employees or their families may from time to time acquire, hold, or sell a position in the securities mentioned herein. Moreover, opinions may differ from one entity to the next. If we are used in connection with the purchase or sale of any security discussed in this report, we may act as principal for our own account or as agent for both the buyer and the seller. Push Button Stock Trading is dedicated to the education of friends, clients, and paid subscribers. Push Button Stock Trading is an information service only. The information provided herein is not to be construed as an offer to buy or sell stocks of any kind. Push Button Stock Trading is created to aid subscribers in making informed investment decisions based wholly or in part on technical analysis. It's possible that at this time, or some subsequent date, the editors of Push Button Stock Trading may own, buy, or sell the investments presented. All investors should consult a qualified professional before making any investment. The information provided has been obtained from sources deemed to be reliable, but it is not guaranteed as to the accuracy or completeness. The editors of Push Button Stock Trading make every effort to provide timely information to subscribers, but cannot guarantee specific delivery times due to factors beyond our control.